Hello everyone and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. I am Exorph and we are having some troubles with this area. We've been killed by a Black Knight and we've been killed by a Knight Slayer. In like the same little area. So I kind of want to try to just run over there and try to ignore everything. Maybe not this guy, just because he's right in my way. But like, I don't want to have to deal with all of this every time. There are a lot of enemies, so we might just... this might not work out, but I want to give it a go at least. This feels like it could be a problem. Like that, yes. Right, and here we go. Yeah, so far so good. I have no idea how far these guys will actually chase me. Possibly to the ends of the earth, but... here's hoping. Here is hoping. And now I kind of actually forgotten exactly where I want to go. I think it's this way, right? And then... down here. Yeah, I think we're good. Now we just need to survive these lizards. Are people still coming after me? And I mean, running away from these should be fine, I would say. So assuming we don't have too many lizards right after us, we might actually be able to get back to this guy fairly quickly. That's kind of nice. And I'm not hearing too many enemies around. So yeah, how do we deal with this? Like, yeah, I do not understand how that's like manageable at all. Huh. Because I tried to roll out of that and I didn't give me much of a chance. So I'm wondering if I'm like underleveled in general. Because this is proving very tricky. I don't want to just run past it either, because that means I'll just... like, circumvent him, but... We might be better off trying something like that. I want to get that item that's next to him as well. You know what? I think I've probably lost those souls anyway, so... let's try this area now. We can try this little path here, first of all. I wonder if these are very different. I mean, I'm assuming that they aren't weak against fire, like... I'm kind of wondering if anything special will happen to them when they attack. Because I'm guessing they won't behave exactly like the regular slimes. I will just speed through this, I believe, unless they actually get to attack. Oh, whoa, whoa. Well, that's different. That's kind of what I was expecting. Alright. And what do we have here? This is probably something that we want to jump over. I don't know if you trigger before. But there's something down there, so we... I wonder if this leads somewhere that we've already been. Oh, nice, another Estus Shard. It's been a while since we got one of those. Wonder if this leads somewhere where we've already been, or if this is another... another fork in the path. There's been a lot of those. I'm so bad at jumping in this game as well. It feels like I'm just starting to learn how to jump in Dark Souls 2 again. Like, you barely do anything when you jump. It's absolutely pathetic, but I guess here goes nothing. Yeah, it worked. And of course, what is the best way of dealing with this? Because the way I usually deal with that enemy is just to get really, really close to it and then pummeling it with attacks. But now there's a slime right over it. It's kind of a nice little design, actually. And anything I do now to trigger that... I guess probably the best way is to deal like this. Make that thing come down before the rock monster actually attacks. Hopefully this will make this come towards me. And then we can deal. Oh, I'm right at the edge. I need to be careful here. Well... this is not working out at all. Jesus Christ, that's a lot of enemies in one place. Okay. This place is driving me insane. Please help me. Oh my god. There's like no place where I can relax at all. Not that I usually relax a lot when playing Dark Souls games, but this is just ridiculous. We can probably run through this place though, I would expect. And then just do that. But like... how do we deal with this now? Whoa! Not really what I had in mind. Yeah, these enemies are not a nice combo, like, at all. They kind of make it very hard to... I guess I'm just not used to really dealing with this many different types of enemies at once. Okay, goddammit, that was close! There we go. Whew. I was just going right into that enemy. Not really thinking that through, one through. But I mean, there's no place to maneuver. Maneuver. Jesus, I just think I realized that I've never actually used that word in speech before. But yeah. Nope, that does not work. Whoa! Get me out of here! Thank you. Man, Jesus. I'm not liking this at all, but seems like it worked out. Oh, and we have more enemies in there. I thought it would be the end of this little path, but I guess not. And all we got was an ember. I thought for sure we would get something more for that. Let's just top up. Oh, okay. I was sure I didn't have full health for some reason. That's the downside of not having the UI up at all times. Anyone gonna notice me? Okay. Finally, a wall that isn't an illusory wall. Anyone else coming for me? I feel like that guy is a trap, but I always feel like everything is a trap. Jesus, that jumping attack is so disorienting. Alright. Managed to deal with that at least. And this place just keeps on going, like there's no end to all of this, is there? Like, at all. Christ. This is insane. Are we, okay, I think I am actually going in some sort of circle now, at least. Because I believe that this is the room with the fire orbs that I was scared of before. In last episode at some point. Oh, you wanna come at me? I hate your shield, but I can probably deal with you. There we go. Thank you. Yeah, you'd come in from the other side of this place, I believe, and then you would go down some stairs. Okay, I don't know if you come down, come in to this place from right below me, or if you come from the other side of this place. Might actually be the other from right below me. I sort of assumed that wasn't the case. Huh. So what do we have here? Please just be the one. Huh. Didn't stagger that guy. Jesus! That's an annoying attack. Yeah, thank you. Oh, and I'm almost fully poisoned now. This might actually be a good place to use a poison moss clump. No, I realized that I never actually read the lore on the budding green blossom. Is there any difference between it? Yeah, there is. Large temporary boost to stamina recovery speed, which is the same thing. Flowers of the green blossom are ethereal, blossoming only on the surface of chilled but not frozen water. Okay, explains why we got it in the Irithyll Valley. Ah, can you please just give me like a moment of respite, a moment to relax? There's been a lot of things thrown at me lately, and I would just like something to go my way for once. Ah, that was horrible. What are you? Are you one of the mages? Did you just heal yourself? Not sure that was really worth it. Oh. There's a lot of smoke. Jesus, it just keeps coming. Alright, thank you. Oh, is that... It looks like all of these statues are from different... enemies? Or different demons? Might be, at least. I feel like that one over there is, I don't want to stand out, so I can't really tell. I'll try to zoom in here. It looks like it's some, like from the Stray Demon or something like that. Possibly the Stray Demon, possibly something else, but still. That's interesting. I'm wondering if this is actually a shortcut to anything, or if it's just like a much harder way of getting here. We'll deal with that later. I'm probably just like skipping over all of the paths that are actually would actually be helpful for me, but I am so very, very worried right now. Okay, so we got another one of those guys. I wonder how easy those balls of fire are to kill. Like, what happens if we just... Oh, that was not at all what I wanted to do. I wanted to first target it. Again, please. Okay, it does have a fair bit of health. Maybe... try to not be... Yes, thank you. Thank you so much for that. Thank you so much for that as well. I do like when it's possible to chain these things together. Does that take care of all of them? Oh, it seems like it does. That's really nice. They are like some sort of fire necromancers, almost. I do appreciate that. We have another pathway down there. I'm guessing it just takes us to the ground floor again. It does. Yeah, it is totally a stray demon or something of that kind. That's interesting. I kind of want to go up there. For some reason, I have a good feeling about that staircase, which seems silly of me, seeing how there's nothing good at all in this area. But I don't know. It looked like it leads into a separate section at least, so perhaps there will be a bonfire or something if I'm really lucky. Like really, really lucky. Like much too lucky. For it to actually be the case. Oh my god. Fucking finally. Alright. Yeah, I kinda wanna do that as well. Yay. Oh my god. Progress. Even though it's not at all in the direction I was hoping for at the beginning of this episode, it's still progress. I'm still very happy about it. Where is this leading us? Oh, are we back in the Smouldering Lake now? Can those arrows reach me from here? Oh, are we above the place where the worm appeared before? So that's the fog door that I was looking at before and went, we need to find a way to get past the worm to actually get in there. I wonder what's on the inside. Oh, we have almost no souls. That's kind of perfect then. Oh, is that a little path? I'll need to try to remember that. I mean, I don't think there has been any fog walls that haven't led to bosses so far. So... I'm expecting this to be a boss. It looks very much like a boss. But it looks very cool as well. Old Demon King. Jesus. Whoa, whoa, whoa. No, thank you. Is this gonna be a one-on-one thing? Whoa! That's not nice! Oh, and it's another fucking one-shot thing! Huh. What is going on here? Why is everything so goddamn dangerous to me? It's a cool, it looks like a cool boss battle though. So I guess we can head back here and try to take care of this, I guess we can just try to take care of the lower area down here. No. Got nothing to lose now. Do we? There we go. Thank you. A chaos gem. I mean, not that I have any reason to upgrade anything on that path just yet. Or, well, did we actually see what they did? You might not have read the lore on those. Relics of lands scorched by the chaos flame. Used in infusion to create chaos weapons. Chaos weapons inflict fire damage and scale with intelligence and faith. So it's basically pyromancy weapons then. That's cool enough, I guess. There's one way of dealing with those. Now where can we actually... Ah, I want that back then! Can you come up here? We'll need you to come in here. Thank you. Ah! No! Okay. Oh, I really hate it when you can, like, run out of stamina and can't really get that one last attack in. How many more do we have to worry about? There's one there. The one on the other side? Probably. Okay. Huh. Did that kill all of them off? Or are there still some left? Feels like there's probably one left or so. But yeah, those aren't as bad as I thought they were at first. I really want to just look at all these statues. And I also want to know exactly what... Yeah, so this is the path that leads down to some rats, and then there's some basilisks, and eventually to the two annoying knights. What do we have here? That's a Taurus demon. That's, I think it's an Asylum demon? Taurus demon. Asylum demon. Taurus Asylum. And I think the Asylum demons might just be, stray demons or whatever. And, so this is the path that, where we saw the Quelag girl before. The Quelag spider. She's over there. It's kind of neat because these statues were close to her as well in Dark Souls 1. It was like, you passed a lot of those to get to an elevator that took you straight up to her. That's kind of neat. Some slimes. Are all of these the same? I think so, yeah. There's nothing... No unique statues here or anything. That, whatever that is, looks cool. That looks like a dead stray demon or other kind of demon. Is that his crush? Whoa, goddammit! The one time. Please don't kill me. Please don't kill me. Like, Jesus, please. Oh my god. I've been so careful. But not careful enough. Alright, and you are down. But yeah, looked like it crushed someone. Possibly the its killer. Oh, and someone that Bone Charged. That's nice. So we can head back to Medulla soon and level up a bit. We also have a new Pyromancer Tome that we want to give to the Pyromancer. I think that one should probably be able to give us what we want. Huh, what's up with this place though? This feels odd, doesn't it? I should probably make sure that they aren't actually, like, still... No, they don't take any damage from firebombs now, apparently. I should probably be a bit careful with these as well. And I'm not careful enough right now. I should probably remember that I don't have a lot of wide angle for my attacks with... with the R2 on this weapon. Right. Survive another ordeal. But yeah, this is feels like a weird little nook. Like, why would this be here? I do notice that they have the same sort of patterns here on these walls. So it's still the same kind of architecture as in Catacombs of Carthus. Which might be interesting. And these swords. I wonder if these are the same swords that the Pyromancers use. Alright. But yeah, I mean, this kind of turned out to be fairly fruitful, after all. You know what, I'm going to end the episode, but... Kind of curious about that path, but no. You know what, let's head back to... Medulla, almost. Let's head back to the Firelink Shrine and level up our stuff. Level up our Estus Flask and level up the Pyromancy Tomes. That makes no sense, but whatever. That's what I want to do. But yeah, I really do appreciate that the game is challenging like this. But it is. I do have that weird feeling that maybe I'm like going up against things I'm not supposed to be going up against, because Dark Souls usually isn't all about like one shot killing you. That's, I can't really remember too many cases of that where you just go into an area and enemies that you're actually supposed to be able to kill you in one hit. But that's kind of, I mean, that's not the case with Irithyll. So maybe that's where I'm actually supposed to go, but in that place it's more like, okay, they kill you in one combo. So it's still a bit tricky. Alright, we gotta burn the shard. No, not burn the dust. Burn the shard, okay. Which will probably help us a bit, at least. And head over here and upgrade our Estus flask.
Just good what need.
Okay.
Pretty big, I don't want.
So I'm so very worried about all of my companions here now, since ever since Joel died. I should probably check in, so just to make sure that he's still a corpse. He sure is. I mean, it's kind of interesting, since what he actually wanted to die. So maybe that's a good thing. Maybe he finally got what he wanted. But doesn't feel like that, somehow. Doesn't quite feel like that. Pyromancy Tome. We should probably try to give all of these, even though we know that he can't teach us Quelana.
Ah, what have we here? A pyromancy tome from Izalith. Then you found the home of pyromancy. Brilliant. I will never curse being old and undead again. Now, show it here, quickly. Let us channel them together. The primal pyromancy is known only to Old Master Salaman.
Old Master Salaman? Huh. So yeah, then it's said that I found the birthplace of pyromancy. I think that's what he said, but something of that kind. I guess that means, if we're to believe him, we actually found Izalith, so we are in Izalith. I thought maybe, I mean, it's kind of obvious that the place has a strong connection to Izalith, but it doesn't seem too clear what that connection actually is. Art of the Flame of Chaos from Ancient Izalith hurls a great chaos fire orb. Chaotic flame melts even great boulders and creates a brief surge of molten lava on impact. The Witch of Izalith and her daughters birthed the Flame of Chaos, but it devoured them along with their home. Art of the Flame of Chaos from Ancient Izalith erects multiple chaos fire pillars in vicinity. The all-engulfing chaos flame eventually formed a tumultuous seedbed, which birthed the twisted things known as demons. I guess that's it. I really want to play as a pyromancer as well. I should probably like start another character and just play on my own time. It would be nice. So that's it, right? Oh, right. We should try to give him the Quelana tome as well.
Ah, what have we here? By the gods, this inscription reads, Quelana, the ancient deity, one of the witches of Izalith. The last of them who wandered the lands. Then she must have returned to Izalith after all. But I regret to say, I cannot accept this. Quelana's pyromancies are for witches and must be learned from a mistress. But thank you for allowing me to peer upon such a thing. If only I were a woman.
Yes, I'm very curious about where we could possibly find a woman pyromancer. I mean, the logical place would be in this area, of course. Or not in this area, but in that smoldering place below the lake.
Heed my words, unkindled one. Fear the fire. The home of pyromancy, Izalith, was scorched by the very fire it created. Undoubtedly, it was a flame of chaos, tangled by a witch's hand. But who's to say that this bonfire's flame is any different?
I think that's new, right?
Heed my feet.
Cool. I guess because we actually got that tome he was talking about before. Alright, but we are heading back to the smoldering... Right, I want to see just how the what it's actually called. Okay, so it's called Demon Ruins. Isn't that what the Isn't that the fireplace in Dark Souls? Kind of want to double check that, but I feel like that is. It is. Yeah, it totally is. Huh. That's interesting. So, is that actually where this place is? Is that actually supposed to be the Demon Ruins? Or is it a different set of Demon Ruins? Huh. That is cool. There's so much lore in this area, and I really wish I, like, knew more about the details of the lore in Dark Souls 1. I'm trying to, like, keep up as well as I can. I'm keeping a big chart of all the characters and all the places, but it's only of this game, really. So, sometimes when details have been explained in Dark Souls 1, it's kind of hard for me to keep track of all of this. But yeah, we'll head to back to the Demon Ruins in the next episode. So thank you all for watching, and I hope to see you next time on Dark Souls 3. Bye-bye!